Okay, so now I'm going to use a picture I had, yes, a selection I did from my pictures, and I think it will work really well for the mist on the trees here on the background. So I can easily paste that on the picture and just delete some parts of the mist here, just adjusting the position of the hill here. I'm just going to use the mist brush as an eraser, so I will keep, you know, the shape of the clouds while I would be getting rid of the white color here. So I will blend with my painting in the background. Okay. Still very bright, but I'm going to do some adjustments after. Also, as it is a separate layer, I can still play with the position of the element. And just move it behind. Kind of, yeah, really too bright, and also have too much contrast on that, so I'm going to get rid of the contrast and do some adjustments for the color. Okay, pretty good. So now we have better blending between the objects. So I still think that in the background we have a too sharp mountain range, and maybe I would need to paint something just to give the feeling of a very far distance mountain range. So I'm still playing with the position of the mist here, but for now I have too much contrast in the background. Like the mountains are really defined, and I really think that we have to block some shapes here. Even it's very, very, very far, so I'm gonna pick up some colors from the far distance clouds and just paint some very rough shapes of mountains here, so we have more depth. We can really, you know, lead the eye in a very far distance point of view. So kind of like, yeah, to have this kind of very, you know, very simple layer, just a silhouette in a very far distance. Okay, just have a look. That's pretty well. So we still need also to break all the geometry we have in the foreground. It's very, very clean and very sharp, so we need to play with that after. Just adding a level adjustment over, you know, on the top of everything, so I'm able to tweak the contrast on all the layers at the same time. Could be interesting also to add this kind of, you know, lakeshore, so we get a nice transition between the lake and the hills, the landscape. So I'm just adjusting the position of the shore here. It's not the perfect scale, but we can still paint over and do some adjustments. It will be just a base for to ground the castle. I have a more interesting transition. Right, so just plugging the shapes basically.